Hey guys, what's up? It's Apollo here. Hope you guys are doing well. And today we're playing Third Age Total War. This is a lore-friendly custom scenario. And I welcome you to the Battle of Weather Hills. So this is a custom scenario made by PaladinBob. And this battle has such a rich backstory. In fact, it's so rich that if I tried to explain it all, we would be here for like 30 minutes before the battle even begins. And I know you kids out there, you got short attention spans. In fact, I'm sure most of you guys are already skipping ahead because you can't sit for like 2 minutes and learn a little bit about this battle and understand the army comps and understand the rules. You just gotta skip ahead straight to the battle, and that is why you're failing math. Think about it. But anyways, for the rest of you guys who do want to know about the backstory, hang around a little bit longer. And for those of you who want to know the entire complete detail of the battle, there's a link down below. PaladinBob went beyond the Call of Duty, wrote out just paragraphs and paragraphs of minor details. You can download the link down below. It's so large that you have to download it. It's just too big to copy and paste in the description. So check that out. Really interesting stuff. All right, so general overview. So Arnor, the year is 861. This is many years before the time of this battle. The Arnorian king dies, and his three sons, his three greedy sons, break up into three different regions for control, for power. So the three regions, we have Rudar, and I'm probably going to slaughter these names, Rudar, Arthedain, and Cardolan. So those are the three regions. You can see them on the screen right now. And so civil war breaks out. And then fast forward to about 1,300 Third Age, we have Angmar, the great Angmarians. The Witch King, of course, seeing that they're weak, seeing that they're divided, and trying to seize an opportunity of conquering their lands, of course, he attacks them. Now, eventually, Rudar falls to the Witch King. They bend the knee to the Witch King, and now they become his minions. But after many wars, many kings die, and soon the only king who has the true bloodline, which is the king of the Arthedain, which is technically what the, he's like the 16th or 17th king of Arnor, he finally gets the Cardolan region to bend the knee to him, and they stand together one last time. One last time against the Witch King, and they try to defend Weathertop. So this is Weathertop, also known as Amon, I think. And over here, of course, these are the mountains of Weather Hills. That's pretty much the story in a nutshell. Not super descriptive, but you know, I'm trying to be quick about it. So I was gonna say one more thing. Oh yeah, historically, this battle is a victory for the Witch King. He burns everything down. He burns down the forest, and both the Prince of Cardolan and the King of Arnor, also King of Arthedain, they both die in this battle. Now we're going back in time, sort of, because this is just a fantasy world. But maybe they can win today. Maybe they can have a victory and change the lore against the Witch King. Alright, so let's talk about the rules here before we get started, because there's a couple rules which makes it really dynamic and interesting. So there's two ways the Witch King and Angmar can win. The first way is taking the top here, sieging Weathertop and taking control of this town center. The other way, which is not an automatic victory, but if they are able to accomplish this, then it's most likely going to be a victory. So this is the supply line going into the mountains here. So you got your weapons, your food, anything the soldiers need. If they lose this supply line, then this, you see the green army on the mini map, they have to surrender. They have to give up because they see no hope, they have no supplies, and they see no reason to continue to fight. Now the other army doesn't have to surrender, but they do have to defend the Weathertop. So that's pretty much it. Of course, the defenders have to completely destroy the attacking armies. So now at this point, let's look at the army comp. So the first army here, there's two defenders. We have Lord Rook, who is defending the force that is mostly defending Weathertop. Of course, he is the Kingdom of Arnor. We got Arnorian heavy archers, standard archers. Of course, he's bringing the dismounted Dúnedain knights and the Dúnedain battle, or the battle-ready Dúnedain. Here's one of the kings, the generals here. So that's a bodyguard unit just on top of Weathertop. And then he does have a couple troops scattered around the base of the mountains. So he's got a catapult, some Arnor pikemen, which are going to be vital in this fight. And of course, we have some heavy archers down below. Now, the other army, which is commanded by PaladinBob, very similar roster. In fact, almost identical. But he does have the, I believe he has the Cardolan forces. So he's defending kind of the mountains out here. And this is going to be a mountainous type of warfare, which is not a pretty warfare. I mean, you got really tough terrain, and you're just going to have a lot of small pockets of fighting. It's going to be a messy struggle for both parties. But yeah, PaladinBob, he's got Dúnedain Rangers, and just, you know, a lot of the similar units that the other armies are consisting of. Let's now move on to the attackers. One more rule I forgot to mention. Only two of these armies that you see, the red armies, can push up first, and then the other armies have to wait 15 minutes before they can advance, so they're kind of like showing up as reinforcements. So the first army here, let's see what we got here. We've got Mordor, commanded by Deadly Sins, which has got orcs. Wonderful orcs. Orc band, orc archers. He's got catapults. In the back, he does have the Rudor scouts. So he's got the men who are now evil fighting for the Witch King. He's got some axemen who have javelin capabilities. And he's also got some hillmen, which is like a basic spear unit. Let's now move on to the next army, which is the Orcs of the Misty Mountains, commanded by Hroros. So he's got warg riders, heavy goblin infantry, and he is also bringing some cave trolls. They've got a cave troll, and here's some orc bodyguard. This is his general. Looks like he's got some blood on him or something. It's just some under red cloth or something. And then he's got Snaga archers for his skirmishing force, and he's already pushing up his goblin infantry to take the mountains, Weather Hills. All right, we'll move on to the next army, which is commanded by Wainy Troll. He's got peasant spearmen, so we got more evil men with the forces of Angmar. He's got a catapult back here, which is actually, they're wearing their Gondor uniforms, don't question it. And the back here, he's got spear militia, so this looks like it's mostly a Rudor type force. Here's axemen, here's tribal spearmen, check them out, whoa. And then we got some heavy axemen, which is a pretty deadly force, and lots of cavs, some Rudor scouts and whatnot. Moving on to the next army, and I believe final army, we got Pimpster Big Money, and he's the Orcs of Gundabad. So he's bringing a catapult and lots of orc band, I can imagine, and I believe some snow trolls in the back, which is fitting because it's very snowy. Orc marauders, goblin bodyguard or orc bodyguard, and some warg riders for his cavalry. And there you have it, guys. Those are the armies. Let's now do normal speed. So we'll head back over this way, where the goblins are pushing in. A couple small legions of goblin infantry. I shouldn't even say legions. Legions are pretty huge. Small ranks of goblin infantry, units of goblin infantry. We do have a couple trebuchet and catapults set up here. Now, I think, unfortunately, Lord Rook is having some difficulties with the trebuchet. In the email that PaladinBob sent me, he was explaining that, yeah, he definitely struggles here, which is a good thing for the attackers, because they definitely don't want that trebuchet operational. And then the Arnorian archers unleash their first volley into the ranks of the goblins. And the goblins are now in loose formation, trying to hug the walls of the Weather Hills to prevent the arrows from getting direct hits on the goblin infantry. Let's see what else is going on here. So we do have the other army pushing forward. So the Orcs of Gundabad taking their time. Now there is a little bit of a defense up here. We got PaladinBob with his Dúnedain Rangers. They're now falling back. He's falling back because I guess he just doesn't want to stretch his army too thin. But he's got a couple more Dúnedain Rangers in the back here. So he's just, you know, he's got a lot of just units scattered everywhere. I mean, you can see it on the minimap. So he's definitely going to be relying on guerrilla tactics, you know, hit and run tactics. Because I don't think Arnor has a strong enough army to just take them on head first with brute force. They really got to use their advantage, use the terrain, and try to skirmish them down. So the warg riders running through the streets. And now we have, oh, here we go. Here we go. The goblin infantry, they're fully committing. And pretty soon, we're gonna get our first infantry charge. Look at the banner carry, he's just going berserk. He's feeling it, guys, he's feeling it today. He had a dream, the night before the battle. An angel appeared to him, she said, just go in like a madman and you'll be all right. Let's see if that prophecy is true. Let's see if that dream is really telling him the truth. Oh, well, so far he's not dead, which I'm quite surprised. I thought he was going to instantly die, and that would have been the joke, but the prophecy might be true. He's bloodied up. He's probably like, where's my friends? Is the Witch King watching? Is he watching? And the spears are now doing a counter charge against the goblin infantry. Look at that. Maybe the prophecy is true. He's still, in fact, his friend over here is getting killed right next to him, but it's not him. It's not him. He's still alive. He's still alive and he's kicking. Wait. No, he's still in the fight, guys. He's still in the fight. Oh my god. Wouldn't it be a miracle that this dude actually survives the entire battle? Wouldn't that just be insane? Me trying to tell a joke. Nope, he's dead. Okay. Nope, that dream is over. Literally, that dream is over. So the angel lied to him. He's like, did the Witch King watch? Witch King don't care about you. Don't worry about the general. General doesn't care about you. All right, so the goblins, they're going to be using their numbers. The catapult is set, not firing, though. So maybe the friendlies are in the way. Maybe he's just waiting for them to blob up a little bit more. This is a pretty big blob, if I do say so myself. And then back over here, we got some Knights of Annuminos, which was once the capital of Arnor. Oh, and we got some catapult fire coming down from the mountains. So we got a bit of a cat fight. Where is that catapult going for? Oh, yeah, just not a good angle. And it's not worth going after this small unit of warg, especially when you have your own knights in the fight. So the wargs are going to disengage, and the Knights of Annuminos are also going to disengage. We have Dúnedain Rangers falling back, and the rest of the forces staying up here. Well, he's got Rangers. Fire! So he's trying to get some pop shots, right? Trying to get some easy kills on the incoming infantry. Now remember, 15 minutes later, the reinforcements will arrive. So you got to try to use your ammo wisely. You don't want to waste it too much on these cheaper units like Goblin Band, because you are going to get tougher units like Trolls and Orc Marauders that, you know, you need to waste your ammo on them because they're not amazing, right? I mean, Orc Infantry is not amazing, but they're certainly better than the Orc or the Goblin Band. So you got to use your, you got to pick your targets wisely. I kept wanting to say tigets. What's a tiget? I don't know. That's the question. I'm going to look it up because maybe it's something. A tiget. Anyways, let's move on. Let's move on from the poor commentary. All right, so trolls have now been charged into the front line, and now the Arnor pikemen, they must now hold to try to keep them back from the catapult. The catapult is now loading up with some shots. Let's see if we can get some miracle life-saving shots here from Arnor's catapult. Here we go, boys. Come on, fire when ready. Boom! Takes out a troll and some goblins. He might have got... he got a lot of friendly fire there. That, you know, like, that kind of takes away from that first shot. That's unfortunate. Now the trolls are pushing through the pikes, and they're going to try to silence this catapult. Let's see if they can get one more volley. This troll's a little undecided. Maybe he's hypnotized by the strange catapult. I don't know. Another shot, mostly killing his own men. He needs to go for the archers back here. That's his best bet. He's getting too many friendly fire hits. What's going on here? We got a fight over on the mountainside as well. Look at this. Goblins charging up the mountainside. We have Arnor militia and some Arnor sergeants trying to hold them back. But this is just, you know, this is the weak first wave of Mordor. Oh, he's able to sneak up some goblin infantry up on the hills. So this is what I'm talking about, guys, about this mountainous warfare. It's very messy. Very, very messy. And just very, I hit my mic there. Very unorganized. So there's the charge. Finally, he's going to silence the Dúnedain Rangers. But will the Rangers be able to fight off this goblin infantry in melee? I would say yes. I think they're pretty good. It's still going to be pretty close. Let's see. They're still going to fire, though. Look at that. Are they going to point blank fire? Nope. They're going to continue to fire at the infantry that is pouring through this choke point. So more and more goblins continuing to push. And the Arnor pikemen just will not break today. They're going to hold their ground. Even though most of the trolls are still alive, they're still in healthy numbers. And we do have some reinforcements from Lord Rook, who's got some battle-ready Dúnedain. All right, let's head back over to the other side. Let's see how the legend Paladin Bob is holding up. So we got Warg Riders coming in as reinforcements. Yeah, not able to break through just yet. Let's see. Let's just make sure we're not missing anything. Look at this. Just look at the endless amount of just funnels and pathways they can take and all the different areas they have to defend. And it's just, they're everywhere. This is like trying to invade Afghanistan. A mountainous, rough, you can't conquer it, all right? So now the Warg Riders, they're gonna commit now and try to take on the Knights of Numenos. Not a fair, they definitely need some spearmen with them because that's not gonna be a fair trade. And plus with the archers putting down suppressing fire, here comes the Knights of Numenos. Charge, Knights of Numenos! There we go, nice volleys from the archers. Very beautiful, wonderful fight. But again, the Warg Riders are just getting butchered. Absolutely butchered. The Knights of Numenos are just, they're laughing. They're laughing at this point. They're like, you call this an army? Oh, except for that guy. That guy's, he's not laughing. He underestimated his opponent. And now he'll pay the price. All right, so we'll head back over to the pretty much, this part's a little bit more cinematic, I would say. A little bit juicier. Look at that, there's a glow. There's a magical glow to these Arnor pikemen who still, they're down to 43 and they're still holding back these orcs. Still holding them back. The archers giving them their best shot. Trying to take advantage of these pikemen who are holding back so many numbers. And more orcs coming in. I mean, it's tough to be an orc. I doubt they even properly train you. They're like, oh, here, grab some leftover metal and sharpen it. That's going to be your sword, okay? Have this block of wood that originally was atop of a crate. Like, look at the armor of these guys. I mean, just like, they obviously, they're just using sheer numbers. That's fine. You know, they've got the numbers. We still got some heavy goblin infantry able to sneak by the front lines, but they're not going to get very far. The battle-ready Dúnedain are going to give them a swift death. A fast death. More and more orc fellers. Look at that. Trying to take out the Dúnedain. We do have Arnor sergeants pouring in, though. Going to give them a taste of justice. Friendly fire coming in, though. That's unfortunate. But these orc fellers are not going to get far. And the Arnor militia still holding their ground. And just look at the glorious... Look at Weathertop back there. That is just... That's glorious. Okay, so this is starting to become a little worrisome for the defenders. Because they don't really have a lot of infantry. And their archers are getting harassed. I mean, you don't want to leave your archers in melee. Their cav is pretty much dead. They didn't really get a lot of good cycle charges there. So just kind of left them in melee, which is okay. You're just holding back these axes. Oh, what is this? Hold on. Hold the phone, guys. Look at this. We've got a diversion force. A sneaky snake force. So they're going around Weathertop. And I guess they're going to go for the back lines, which there's some reserves waiting for them. But that's pretty smart. That's a good idea to try to overwhelm your opponents from many different locations. And look at the mess here. This is just a mess of trolls, dead orcs, dead humans, still fighting for this little opening in the walls. The snow trolls now committing into the fight. I believe the original trolls that charged in a little bit earlier, they are now dead. They've been fighting for a long time, so I assume they're dead. And we'll head back over to the other side, where we have Dúnedain Rangers. What are they firing at? Let's see. Oh, we got wargs up here. How did they get up here? I guess you can... What? Maybe they... How, no, seriously, though. Did they climb up here? How did they get up here? I don't get it. That's all right. These wargs are not going to last long. They're going to take out a couple archers, but it's not going to be, like, game-changing or anything like that. And, of course, we have the battle-ready Dúnedain close behind. The cavalry of Rohan, or not Rohan, Arnor. God, I hope I haven't been saying Rohan. The cavalry of Arnor has been very effective so far, protecting this pathway, just cav alone. And look at all of the fallen orcs. Look at that. There's just a trail of dead orcs, especially right here. My goodness, these archers all face down in the snow, dead, dead. All right, so let's head back. The reinforcements have not arrived yet. Remember, 15 minutes. They do have catapults, so that's going to be pretty effective against these heavily defended areas. But these two armies, I mean, they took a lot of casualties here. Like, I don't really have a lot of hope for these orcs. It just doesn't seem like they're going to be able to pull through. But look at that balance of power. It is greatly in favor of the orc armies. So let's not assume anything just yet. The orcs have plenty of troops to win this one. They just got to be smart about it. And I think so far, even though they've lost a lot of garbage, you know, like cannon fodder. They just threw in the garbage troops, and maybe they're just trying to get the enemy to waste their ammo. But it appears that finally they're going to be able to take control of this bottom location. And now the defensive armies of Arnor falling back. We got some hobbit archers here, which we did not originally see. So fantastic. The hobbits are here. So they're going to fall back. They're even falling back the catapult, which is a smart idea because you want to use this catapult on this very steep hill that leads to Weathertop. And this is pretty much it for his army. So not a lot of troops. And he's going to be taking on a fresh full army, which is now on the move, guys. 15 minutes has passed, at least in-game 15 minutes. I don't know about the actual replay. But yeah, it's passed, and now they're moving up, and we've got fresh legs, fresh bodies to just throw into the front line. Unfortunately, for this side, though, they haven't had any luck against Paladin Bob and his mighty cav forces. So I don't know if they're just going to give up on this location, or maybe they're just going to, maybe they're going to wait for the reinforcements and push over more troops, or, you know what, by the looks of it, it appears that they're going to send everything down the center. I think they are going to give up on that side because it's just, it's a death trap. It's a kill zone. I mean, what are you supposed, I mean, this is just ambush city. Just trying to go through these mountain paths and just getting cut down by arrows. So I think that makes sense to just not pursue that location and go for Weathertop. Oh, Knights of Menumenas, Paladin and Bob sending over some aid. Trying to cut down, it looks like, some goblin archers, but we do have the Rudar scouts. They're now going to pursue the knights. Nope, they're going to disengage. Disengage. And so the evil forces continue their march. Wait, what? We got a little fight here. What is it? Excuse me, pardon me. Excuse me, fellow orcs. I must get to over here. What is this guy doing? Is he breaking? It's the trebuchet crew. Where is the lone trebuchet crew bannerman going? Now he's stuck on a hill. What the heck? That's awesome. Okay, so I think what we're going to do here... Oh, wait, hold that thought. I was going to say we're going to fast forward, but it looks like we got more action, guys. Catapult spraying down some shots. This is a catapult from Paladin Bob, who's got them in position. Now he needs to watch out from his flank because look at this. We do have warg riders. Finally, the flanking forces are just now making their way over. This infantry still has a long way to march, but they have to defend. They absolutely have to defend this supply line. So Paladin Bob, he cannot commit all of his forces towards Weathertop because, again, he's got to defend the supply line. So it should be interesting to see how Paladin Bob approaches this situation. The trebuchet crew. Yeah. Yeah, see, their trebuchet glitched out, unfortunately, for Arnor. That sucks. I mean, they potentially could have gotten hundreds of kills with that catapult. Alright, so now they're gathering up their forces, but they gotta move fast. You can see they've got a lot of troops just, you know, marching in, getting ready for the main assault. This is gonna be a very challenging assault. They're gonna need their archers, they're gonna need their artillery, and they've gotta watch out for defending artillery, which is, well, they're not quite firing. The defending artillery still falling or pulling back, falling back up to the hill. It was weird for me to say falling back because they're going up a hill, you know? I don't know. But yeah, they're retreating. They're retreating. Back over on this side, more and more cav pouring through the abandoned pathways of this side. Now, we got some archers firing down some arrows on these scouts, but the scouts are going to keep pushing. They're just going to run right by them. And honestly, what else are you supposed to do, you know? What can you do against all those archers, against all that reckless hate that is just waiting for them on the mountainside? I guess they're coming around this way. I think they're going to actually try to go for this this catapult and the archers. I think that's exactly what we're doing, or that's exactly what they're doing. Arnor Knights showing up as reinforcements, charging into some spearmen. So Arnor not done yet. This is Paladin Bob's Knights. And then we got a flank here from the Rudar Scouts. The evil men's scouts. They butchered the goblin band, but they need to get out of that prolonged melee. But they're going to lose a lot to the spears. And we got more reinforcements. Orc Marauders, a unit of 48. Charge! Surround the enemy cav! Except they're goblins, so they don't, you know, they're orcs. They don't sound like that. They're not as elegant. Oh, they surrounded some cav in the back. It looks like this is the end for Paladin Bob's glorious cav that fought so bravely so far during this battle, defending the pathways of Weather Hills. And are they going to commit? No. That's what I thought. Don't commit. Go for that catapult. This is a great move by this player. And the rest of the evil forces, they're still making their way to the supply line. They have some warg riders. Could certainly use these warg riders right now. Alright, let's watch the point of view of these knights. Or not knights, scouts. Knights. Alright, here we go. Come on, get your charge in. Get your charge in. Okay, don't slow down. The archers are gonna fire like crazy on you. The archers are gonna stand their ground and try to kill as many before they charge in. But instead of going for the archers, he's gonna go for the catapult. I assume it's be- oh wait, no, he split up his cav. They're going for both targets. So that was a great move right there. Great use of the scouts. He should kill the catapult crew. At least most of them. Most of them. But we'll see. I don't know if he has enough to kill the Dúnedain Rangers. Okay, that's a pretty good move. He's gonna disengage, maybe do another cycle charge. So the Rudar scouts. Oh, this lone Dúnedain. Oh, he's dead. Yeah, the catapult crew is dead. He went in back for another charge. Very, very good use of micro here. And I think he's going to continue to do those cycle charges. Let's head back over to this side. Where we have fresh troops now making their way to the top of this mountain. Okay, so if we look at these forces, it's very obvious that they're concentrating. Look at this army. They're concentrating most of their troops to take Weathertop. And they're not going to really go for the supply line. That's not necessarily completely true, because we do have the flanking force. But is this enough troops to capture the supply line and make the second army surrender? Or the defense is going to hold? You know, are they going to be able to stop this flanking force? It's going to be tough to say. It's going to be really tough to say. And it seems like they're just waiting for the perfect moment to strike. Wait, now they're charging forward. All right, so we'll head back this way where the archers are still getting attacked. Oh, we got some cav from Arnor. Depleted cav, which it looks like they are going to save the archers, what's left of them, but they are not going to save the catapult. That's unfortunate, because right about now, shooting that big blob of troops, I think that was well played. This is actually really well played by the attackers. Great strategy. You notice how there's a huge blob of troops just now moving? That's because they're waiting to silence this catapult up here. So it was great teamwork, great use of cav. They silenced the catapult, then they mobilized the armies, and now the army is ready to siege Weathertop, already firing down some shots. Now we got a bit of a catapult battle, and this is intense. Definitely don't want to be, I'd much rather be controlling the catapult that's firing downhill, obviously. But let's see if it gets any good hits. Ooh, yeah, it's going to take out some archers. Oh my god, look at that. That is beautiful. That is absolutely beautiful. The fight. Look, you can see the armies down below and the mountains in the background. Gorgeous. Oh god, incoming! Now, way over their heads. Way over their heads. Oh, that one was not... That was actually really close to destroying one of the catapults. Alright, so they're forming up. You gotta be careful though, you can't let them sit back for too long. They've got tons and tons of catapults. So they're gonna take this nice and slow. Alright, hold the phone guys, look at this! So the flanking forces, the Wargriders are going in, attacking the Arnorian archers, and they're gonna disengage right before the reinforcements arrive. And look at the background with the Weathertop, man, that is so cool. Seeing Weathertop back there, that's gorgeous. And then of course, the very awesome looking Dúnedain Knights. Okay, so Wargriders, they're gonna try to squeak on by. They definitely need to send up some infantry, which they are, but of course, they're very tired already. They've been marching a long way, and now they have to march uphill. So they're not gonna be super effective, and the Wargriders are getting destroyed by these Arnorian archers. And I'm so glad they buffed up the wargs in Reforged, because this is sad. I mean, this brings me back. It's like, why even bring warg riders if they're gonna get butchered by archers? That was a good charge, but it's not gonna do a ton. Look at the fiery balls of justice just randomly flying by in the background. God, this is a long battle, guys. We're not even halfway through it yet. My goodness. Alright, so he's going to disengage with the wargs, which is probably a smart idea. These warg riders are going to continue to push and go after these hunters. So we've got a low-quality missile troop, the hunters, which I assume are, you know, part-time hunters, part-time archers for emergencies like this. But the archers are, well, they're going to be taking on the ultimate game, so to speak, of wargs. But yeah, they lost about half their unit in that charge, maybe a little bit less. The warg riders falling back. We still have a catapult up here. Oh my god. It almost gets a really good hit. That would have been one impressive snipe. So it's kind of like they just are ignoring this small force of troops. Yeah, because Arnor still has a ton, which they're staying close by of the supply line in case they have to fall back. Oh, there's their general. The general saw some action. Oh, he's got a lot of troops up here, too. Okay. So, yeah, Paladin Bob, remember, he's got to defend that supply line. He doesn't want to surrender. This is going to be some troubling times, guys. I don't know. Paladin Bob's about to meet a mega force of justice trying to take the supply line. Let's head back over to Watchtower. Let's see if they're attacking yet. No surprise here. They're going to continue to skirmish the enemy. The enemy. They're going to push up archers. They're going to push up catapults and soften them up. Well, we still have fighting here, though. The warg riders playing a little game of pickle. Pinballing back and forth between the dismounted Dúnedain knights and the hunters who are mostly dead. And this poor soul is stuck in the air. Oh, we got some cav now going in. Gonna take out these hunters. So some reinforcements coming in from the orcs of Gundabad. And now the wargs completely surround the dismounted Dúnedain knights. But I think they're strong enough to hold their own against the very weak warg riders. This infantry needs to commit. and they should probably attack with more infantry down this way, but look at the amount of losses. And this is probably 99% the attackers. My god. Just a trail of death. Could you imagine, like, being the reinforcement army, and it's, like, foggy out so you can barely see, and you see just this, like, horrifying pathway, and you just see a trail of dead comrades, and you're commanded to go into the mountain pass and fight whatever they fought? It'd be horrifying. Absolutely horrifying. Alright, so this is not good for the Dúnedain Knights. Now surrounded by infantry and some scouts. Archers are trying to give them support. We got Arnorian archers. The goblins are going to send up some of their infantry to try to take out those archers. We're still not halfway through the battle, guys. Alright, this alone archer, really, is it worth it? Just take him out. He's like, come and get me. Come and fight me. Who wants some? Come on. He's like, I'm gonna kill every one of you. Kill me. Oh. Nope. They're gonna let him. Why would you leave me live? He sees all of his fallen friends. He's like, why? You terrible monsters. He doesn't get a kill, though. Wow. Amazing. So the scouts are gonna turn back, take on a much more threatening target, which is the Dúnedain Knights. And oh, that was a devastating blow. And now the infantry should be able to clean them up. Sure enough, Paladin Bob's infantry is breaking. And the heavy goblin infantry now silencing the Arnorian archers. And the lone hunter. So come back. Why won't you give me a warrior's death? You bastards. So he's gonna go over there and try to meet up with the enemy. Give him a piece of his mind. Tell him what's up. Alright, so more reinforcements coming back this way. So orcs of the Gundabad. They're coming back here. Again, they really want to get that supply line, and they are making great progress. They could take it. I mean, they can go down this hill. They can attack this opening path here. So, if they take the supply line, the other army has to surrender. But to be fair, I think by the time, if they do take the supply line, they will kill most of the second army anyways. So, yeah, it doesn't really matter if they take it, because they'll kill the army regardless. These Arnorian archers are actually putting up a decent fight. A surprising fight indeed. Let's head back over to the main struggle. This is like where the showdown is going to go down, so to speak. He's greatly outnumbered. I mean, he's got some pretty elite units back here, but they're so outnumbered. I don't know. I mean, he's got a lot of archers. That's good. I don't know if he has enough. I mean, unless these orcs are just trash. I mean, they've got trolls, they've got catapults, and they're still just sitting back and enjoying the sights. Here we go. We got our first charge of infantry and archers. They are gonna go for this defensive location. We got the trebuchet crew going out like a bunch of heroes. Like, who wants to live forever, men? Meet me down at the base of Amon-Sul. There we will face our enemies. There you will truly know who you really are. Oh no, they're falling back. So I think this is gonna just continue on. Nothing really going on there. It looks like both armies just waiting for the other army to make a move. Really, it's up to the attackers to make a move, because, well, they're attacking. And the Arnorian archers, finally they break upon against such numbers. And now this is the fight. This is the epic fight for the supply line. We've got archers stationed in strategic locations. We've got Arnor men-at-arms, Arnor heavy archers, and some Arnor pikemen. Let's see if it's enough, though. And of course, we have the reinforcements coming this way. Actually, he's going back. So maybe they're like, you know what? You got it. I think he needs to go back the other way. He needs to support and kill the supply line. That's interesting. Because I don't think this amount of forces right here is going to be enough. Yeah, this is clearly not going to be enough. Oh, we got infantry, guys. Infantry charging in. And the catapults are now releasing hell upon these attackers. So this is where I can imagine this replay is about to get real grindy. Real grindy. Spear militia holding back the hillmen of Rudar. You gotta roll your R's every single time. Lots of archer support. Fantastic to see that. The defenders are taking on some enemy archer fire. Yeah, there's the goblin trackers. They're trying to get a better vantage point here, trying to go up the hill a little bit, get a better angle to the enemy. More and more forces pushing forward. He is getting that catapult a little bit closer. We got some orc fellers. And we've got orc marauders. They're exhausted though. So that's the thing. I think even if you walk up this hill, it's gonna be a tough day for you. I mean, it's gonna be brutal because it's so steep. It's gonna make your troops so tired. Yeah, but these hillmen have no chance. They're down to a handful of troops. And I think it's time to send up the reinforcements. Send up extra troops to fight for this choke point. And let's go back here. Where Paladin Bob has now abandoned the supply line and now approaching the attacking forces who are stuck on a hill. And yeah, you know, this is a smart move by Paladin Bob because he realizes that, hey, why do I need to sit back and wait for these orcs to attack me when I can butcher these guys right now and then I can support the men who are defending Amensul, or Weathertop, because I'm probably mispronouncing that. Oh, and there's the hunter, guys! There is the hunter still alive! He's like, come on, you bastards! You took everything from me, left me with nothing! And you won't even give me the honor of dying in battle. Oh, he's getting some hits. Oh, look at that, that's awesome! Except two of them got stuck. Like, move out of the way, hunter! That was cool. Look, he's all bloodied up. Like, I've seen things, man. I've seen some messed up things. Put me in the fight. Put me in, coach. Oh! Is he gonna die here? No, he's taking out his dagger. He's taking out his dagger and he's getting some kills. He might as well be fighting with his bare hands, choking. Oh, he's dead now. And there goes the last of the hunters. Dead. But he went out like a champion. And he had nothing to lose. And that's how we should live our lives, guys. Nothing to lose. Oh, I'm just kidding. Don't listen to me. Alright, so yeah. They should win this fight. It's unfortunate that they're not sending over more reinforcements this way to support them. To try to take the supply line. But I guess it's not that important because most of Paladin Bob's army is dead. Oh, good hit there. That was perfect timing. More hillmen being committed to the fight. So again, they're sending in their weaker troops first. Again, trying to absorb that ammo. Trying to absorb the catapult ammo and soften up the defenders. Now we got battle-ready Dúnedain, which is not a cheap unit for the defenders. So you have to question, did the defenders even have enough troops if they're already sending in some battle-ready Dúnedain? The epic grind fest continues on. So while that's going on, let's head down here. Let's see what they got. So they got catapults. Again, they've got a lot of reserves. holding back their more elite units like the Sword Militia, which it's pretty funny to say that more elite Sword Militia, but it's true. Orc Fellers, of course, the catapults are hanging back. And then way back here, we got Orc Band. So they could probably send up the Orc Band next. They're next in line once they need to send up more reinforcements. But this is going to be a tough struggle. And let's not forget about Paladin Bob. I mean, even though he has a small army at this point, he can win the day. Like, he could show up like the Riders of Rohan at Pelennor Fields. God, I'm so nerdy. And they could show up and they could flank around and do a lot of damage to this army while they're so focused on taking out this hill defense. Alright, so the hillmen once again starting to get softened up. They are no match to the battle-ready Dúnedain. More and more forces coming in. Orc fellers, let's do this. Oh, the catapults! It took out one of their catapults. That is a devastating loss for the defenders. Wow, didn't think that was gonna happen so quickly. Here comes another shot, actually getting really close. Well, not that close. But the relentless artillery bombardment from the attackers. This could be a game changer. Oh yeah, softening up those archers. Now the archers are getting a little bit higher, trying to get a better angle to the enemy archers. Look at the angle, look at that, boom! The thunder of that catapult flying by. Beautiful. Just a beautiful battlefield. Oh, and it takes out the other catapult. And that's it. That's all she wrote for the defending catapults. Do they have any more? No, that is it. That is a huge, huge, devastating loss to the defenders. Really not much it could have done about that. It's just bad luck. I mean, look. Sorry about that. I hit my mic again. Look how far away that the catapults are. And they're just able to snipe the defending catapult. That is insane. Absolutely insane. Now we have the axemen using up their javelins before they go into the fight. That's a good use of javelins. You know, try to kill the battle-ready Dúnedain from afar instead of up close. So the epic bloodbath for the single spot is still underway. Arnor will not be pushed away. They will hold, not budge. Okay, so while that's going on, let me see what's going on in the mini-map here. So we can see a couple troops. These guys are breaking. So I think it's safe to assume. See, what's this? What if he's just got this 7 orc band waiting for Paladin Bob to leave his supply line, and just he's going to charge in with the 7 orc band and be like, oh, it's ours now. Sorry, Paladin. You got to surrender. But that would be pretty fun. I'm sure he's going to leave behind one unit of militia just in case of something like that. But he's pushing up more of his army. Where is his army exactly? Oh, they're going down the mountainside. So I think they are headed for Weathertop. But we'll see how effective they are. We do have some reserves. I guess you could call this the rear guard. They're going to move over and protect the flank. Waiting for Paladin Bob. Alright, so now the attackers. Now that the catapult has been destroyed, I can sense that they're feeling more confident. And they're going to go ahead and risk sending up more infantry to the front line. Because they don't have to, you know, they don't have to worry about losing 100 troops in one catapult shot. Because now that it's dead, not much to worry about. Of course, they still have their catapults. Oh, just brutal, brutal attack. And the balance of power is still way in favor. Actually, the percentage killed, look at that, it's pretty even. Now, of course, the attackers have more troops, so technically they've lost more numbers. But again, percentage-wise, it's pretty even. Okay, so I think for... Well, hold on. So what do we have here? There's a green arrow, but just see... Oh, it's a lone... It's a lone Dúnedain! Look at him. He's like, I will snipe the enemy. That's beautiful. But anyways, what I was saying is, since this is really just a grind fest, Just for time's sake, we're gonna do times 2 speed, which is still quite enjoyable, but this battle replay is insanely long, and there's really not much for me to talk about, at least not tactics-wise, so we're gonna speed it up a little bit and just see how long this grind lasts. It should be interesting to see. All they really have to do is break through the battle-ready Dúnedain. Once they do that, then it's pretty much fair game. They just have to take on archers and a couple infantry reserve that are on top of Weathertop. All right, but stay close attention to Paladin Bob's army, which is making their way closer and closer to the back lines of the attacking force. Let's go ahead and see their situation right now. I think he's sending up some archers this way. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is turn. See, this was a pretty basic battle for these attackers so far, but now it's turning into a much more difficult situation where they're now having to worry about their back flank because we got archers who are just going to get in range here and fire down to that orc band. So they're going to now just leave. They're going to get out of range, get out of town, away from those heavy Arnorian archers, which are going to fire a couple volleys. Let's get another volley. Come on. For Arnor. So yeah, they're firing at the backs of this Uruk bodyguard. Keep pushing, bodyguard. Keep pushing. Get out of range. Yeah, so they're evacuating the army, getting them closer to the front line. So this is actually becoming extremely close. The battle-ready Dúnedain down to 16 men. And the infantry still making their way. Alright, some more infantry going to the front line. He's got some axemen, which I believe still have their ammo, some javelin ammo. And we've got a fresh couple units of sword militia. 100 men in this sword militia unit. And they're actually going to just squeak on by. They're going to run right by those battle-ready Dúnedain and go for the archers. The archers, look at the aftermath of the constant bombardment from the enemy artillery. So the archers are going to fall back. And now we have, what is it, some men-at-arms holding the very top of Weathertop. And this is going to be it, guys. The final stand for Weathertop. And just a beautiful, beautiful sight. It's so awesome. I love it. It's such a gorgeous structure. Yep, the attackers have finally broken through the epic stand of the battle-ready Dúnedain. They're now making their way. Let's see what Paladin Bob is doing over on this side as well. Well, he's fallen back. And he's got Arnor men-at-arms and, of course, his archers, his general pikemen watching the flank just in case the attackers send anything sneaky over there. But I think he's just playing the waiting game. He's playing the waiting game. He's going to wait for these attackers to put their guards down. And then he's gonna full on attack. Oh, here we go. Here comes the charge down the hill. A downhill charge. Archers giving him support. Excellent. Excellent move. Unfortunately, wow, they're still able to get off their javelin throw there. Their volley. But that was a smart idea to close in the gap between them and the axemen so that they don't just sit there and get, you know, javelin to death. Picked apart from afar. Alright, so the grind continues on. Archer fire, beautiful location for these archers. Getting a great angle to the enemy. Fire. Wonderful. So Arnor, they're doing pretty well against these axemen, especially with the support of the archers. Let's see, they're still down to 78. Fresh reinforcements are about to charge in. Yeah, see, this is actually really wise for the defenders to hold at this point. Because again, you got the flanking firepower from his archers. A lot of the shots are going into the dirt, but that's okay. He's still getting some contact with the enemy. And the reason this is so good too is because the catapult, if you get the catapult up here, it has no angle to the defending forces. It could try to focus down the infantry here, but yeah, this is just a well solid defense from the defender. Also keep a little check here on this mini map. Paladin Bob, I'm watching his army motions here, his army formation, seeing if he's gonna go in. Now we have some Arnorian archers who I assume used up all their ammo, now joining the front line, holding back this horde of orcs and evil men. Nice charge from the trolls. So now the trolls have been committed to the front line, realizing that this is a pretty desperate situation. He can't just sit back and get picked apart from archers in the flank. Now using fire arrows, trying to scare their morale or destroy their morale. Scare their morale. What does that even mean? You're scaring my morale. Stop it. But the troll is just smacking down overhead smash, killing a couple men at a time. Look at that. Beautiful. More trolls coming up. You got a snow troll. We even have a general in the front line. So they're making a desperate push. Look at this push. And Paladin Bob, look at, he's just grinning. He's just smiling. He's feeling good. He's like, oh, look at him desperately pushing in. We do have a couple units of cav, some scouts. They're really not going to do much. Going for the general. Look at that. He's trying to kill the general, which is a good idea. But the general's going to be able to sneak past by him, squeak on by, and the cav's going to disengage. And that's going to be it for that engagement. But oh my god, they still have tons of infantry, guys. And the attackers are breaking through. They've got to send up more infantry, which he has some Arnorian heavy archers. But does he just have archers? No, he's got some Dúnedain knights, but I think that's it when it comes to professional infantry. The rest is just hobbits and their archer hobbits, which is even worse, instead of like hobbitry and arms. So there you have it. The trolls continuing to push their way through. Oh my god, careful trolls, don't fall down. That's what I would do, just try to push the trolls down. I don't know how you would do that, because trolls probably weigh like a ton. Oh, the catapult's getting in place. The trolls are actually going back down. God, they still have a ton of troops. This battle is far from over, guys. Now Paladin Bob is finally mobilizing his army. He's gonna get them in position. He's gonna get ready to attack the back lines. It's not gonna be, you know, I don't know if he has enough. I mean, he definitely has enough to cause some issues for the attackers, but I don't know if this is gonna be enough to save the defenders. The balance of power is still greatly in favor of the attackers. We'll see what happens though. We'll definitely see what happens. Oh wow, arrows going through the brick wall there. Beautiful. The trolls are dead. That or he retreated the trolls. It looks like he did retreat his snow trolls. He's gonna save them for another time. I think he's just trying to get them away from that the archer fire. We got some special abilities. We'll now do normal speed. Just enjoy the fight. Don't want the whole battle to be in double speed. God, look at that background. I still can't get over that. It's just a gorgeous mountain range. It's actually just okay. Yeah, the relentless artillery fire is really chewing up these attackers. They've got to try to break through these forces fast. Hopefully, these guys are running out of ammo. They are taking some counterfire. They've lost a couple archers. I wonder if it's because, do we have archers down here trying to fire? Yeah, we do. But again, it's not exactly a great angle. He's got some scouts. Looks like they're forming them up. There we go. They're breaking through. Now's their chance to cut up those archers, seek revenge for their fallen comrades. There's the general. Is that the general? Yes, the general is in a unit of 6. No, that's not the general. Can't be. Or is it? Yeah, that's the general. He's giving out commands. Look at the arrows just flying right by him. A couple hit there. That's okay. It's just
a flesh wound. Just a flesh wound.
Because, you know, the goblins are like uneducated English people. I don't. That's what they sound like. Alright, so are they gonna. Oh my god, look at the arrows! Just a crazy amount of arrows. The general. I think he's going for the archers. But yeah, this general's really lucky. He hasn't died yet from enemy archer fire. There we go, he's gonna charge! He's got a small unit of 4 men, not including him. They're gonna go in and try to cut up these archers, silence them once and for all. And now the great fight for the town center. The battle is going to come to a close right here. Let's go back this way, though, because Paladin Bob, he's got his army in position. Look, he's forming a bit of a protective box around his archers, which is honestly the best thing he can do, trying to soften up these defenders. I don't know. I still think the defenders are going to need a miracle to win this one because of the sheer numbers of the attackers. But we'll see. I mean, the troops here are quality troops. So Arnor now desperately fights for the base of Weathertop. Come on, put your pikes down. Put your pikes down. There they go. A little late. Well, better late than never, I suppose. Oh, we even have some trolls. They're here to finish off Paladin Bob's army once and for all. Oof, now they're firing catapults. God, they really want this army dead. So now he's going to send in his archers and try to kill these trolls. He still has some archers back in reserve. Oh, the catapult hits their own troll and kills mostly their own infantry. That's a huge loss. Oh, another friendly fire shot. That is huge. And the trolls are dead. The trolls are dead. Now, they were catapult trolls, which I guess are just like weaker trolls, but still strong for winding up a catapult. But still, I mean, trolls are trolls. And there goes one of the goblin Okay, so that was the general we were watching earlier. He charged into the archers. Not enough. Now we have the king who's defending this hill, actually charging down the mountainside. And we've got fresh reserves pushing up. Are the defenders, are they going to save the day? The balance of power is slightly shifting back in their favor. They're able to cut down this catapult that's out of position because they did not have reserves in place. And their army were not, the troops that they sent in were not strong enough to break the wall of men. The dismounted Dúnedain knights, and the general dies to the archer force. That's unfortunate. This is the general's bodyguard. He's now getting the heck out of there because we got fresh reserves. But can they still hang on? I don't know. I mean, that's a lot of troops. That's a lot of enemy forces left over. Let's see if Paladin and Bob, well, he's still hanging on. Paladin and Bob is still hanging. The general, look at the general. He's still, this is the Prince of Cardolan or whatever. Whatever you call it. He's going back and forth. He's charging in, getting hammer and anvil strikes. The swordsmen about to win their fight. They are getting outflanked by some scouts, though. That's all right. All right, so we're down to like the last 10, 15 minutes of the battle. And I still, well, if this was like 5 minutes ago, I would say that the attackers have this one. But I think there's a chance now. There is a chance for these defenders. Look at that. That is so cool. I love that like pillar structure back here. So Weathertop, so awesome. And the archers, man, the hobbits, the Arnorian archers, the heavy Arnorian archers, chewing them up. So now they only have one infantry unit, but again, they're holding a small location. If 300 taught me anything, the small force against many is an equal fight
in a close quarter situation. There's probably a better way for me to explain it, but you know what I'm talking about. And we have the king going into the struggle. So he's trying to support his infantry. Uh-oh. Gotta watch out for this big bad catapult. Oh my god, there's no way. There's no way! There's no way the defenders can win. There's just too many troops. Too many. And Arnor, it appears Arnor is gonna put down their lives. The reinforcement Arnorian forces. I mean, he still has a solid amount of troops. He still has a lot of archers. His pikemen are still alive. Which his pikemen should win this fight because, you know, they're taking on Orc Band. Arnorian heavy archers now using them as infantry against the peasant spearmen, which they should be. And more infantry coming up this way. Dismounted Dúnedain knights. They're holding their own. They're supported by some Arnorian heavy archers who I assume used up all their ammo. What is that? Do you see that? What is that? Fiery balls of... What the hell is that? Is that the catapult? Oh my god, the catapult firing straight up in the air. That is too much. I was like, look at that. I love that. Just breaking the laws of physics. But this is a fantasy world, so anything's game. There goes another general. Another general dead on the battlefield. The attackers only have two more. Here comes another. Watch out. The sky is falling. The sky is falling. Get out of here, men. Arnorian heavy archers. Gonna surround the orc band. And we got the general breaking. Wow, Arnor's general slowing down the reinforcements, buying time for their infantry to chew up what's left of this army. There's the king. You can see his crown on his head. The last king that traces back to Isildur. Boom, get him. Oh wait, that's not the king, he just died. That's the king, the last king. They all look like kings. Their helmets look like crowns. And that was the Witch King you heard. He's also on the battlefield somewhere amongst the troops. There he is. There's the Witch King. He's now needed in the front line, sieging Weathertop. Arnor's still in the fight. Wow, Paladin Bob still has an army. His general, the Prince of Cardolan. It's like, come on, men. We must save these defenders, even if it means the death of us. So they're gonna show up as reinforcements. And I think for time's sake, we're gonna do times two speed. The balance of power, just out of nowhere. I didn't even notice it. The balance of power, oh no. Wait, is that the king? The king is dead. The king is dead. The one true king of Arnor has been killed. Now, historically, that happened in the battle. Let's see, with the death of their king, they're gonna have enough to take this. I mean, more and more troops coming up. Paladin of Bob's close behind. They've got to break through these knights. If they can't break through the knights, there's no way they're gonna win this one. But as soon as they do break through, I mean, look at the layers. The defenders, I mean, they're not, or the attackers. Oh no, the prince is now dead. And again, that's also historical. The prince and the king died in this fight. Now, of course, they lost the battle, but there might be a victory in this based on the balance of power, or there might be a victory for the defenders based on the balance of power, because all we really have left is Orc Band, and that's just unfortunate. Well, those are some fresh troops. The Witch King's still doing his screams, still doing his abilities. times two speed as we watch the brave knights of Arnor fight on, even though their leaders are dead, because they have no other choice. It's either fight here and die, or they could just jump off the cliff of Weathertop. But you might as well just fight, have a warrior's death, and who knows, you might even survive. Who knows? He's holding back his reinforcements. No, no, Paladin Bob's, his archers were able to sneak up behind. Oh man, where's his pikemen? Oh, his pikemen are, where did the, oh, the catapult crew sneaking up on the pikemen, trying to slow him down so reinforcements don't arrive. So I don't know if Paladin Bob is, I mean, let's have a little question here. If you think Paladin Bob, think that Paladin Bob, if he didn't have that extra force, do you think the attackers would win? Do you think this small force from Paladin Bob was the deciding factor in this battle or not? Was he just kind of like a, you know, like a distraction? Oh man, that's crazy. That is insane. Now it appears that most of these archers are out of ammo, so they're now picking up their swords, picking up some shields from fallen soldiers. And we are coming down to the wire of this battle. Right, could you imagine if I didn't times two speed it? Like, this would be 2 hours long. It would be insane. Arnorian heavy archers, they're still alive, down to, see, they're down to 24. They've killed a lot of these axemen, which is surprising. I mean, professional axemen against archers. And the catapult crew. Oh, Dúnedain rangers. Where did these guys come from? I didn't even know he had rangers left over. So Paladin and Bob just spawning men. It's like, do the orcs spawn or do the men spawn? Seriously. So this is the final grind. I think it's safe to say that the attackers are going to win this one. So we're going to time six speed it for time's sake. So, yeah. They've got fresh reinforcements. The Witch King is nearby, I assume. Where is the Witch King? There he is. There's the Witch King staying close by, keeping the troops' spirits high. But, he's got like Orc Band and Peasant Spearmen. I don't think it's going to be enough, guys. And here comes the axes. This is it. I think the Witch King just charged in as well. Yep, there he is. There he is. Oh, he's falling back. Oh, he broke. The Witch King broke. And they're surrounded. Dúnedain and the defenders win today's battle, thanks to Paladin Bob and the great stand from the defender of Weathertop, which was Lord Roke. So great battle, great fight. And we'll just fast forward. Just the last couple orcs putting up their final stand. And that is gonna wrap it up for today. So I wanna see these stats, see how well everyone did. Oh, come on, what's left? Come on. Oh, it's the Witch King putting up his final stand. He's dead. But, you know, they might have won today, but it's inevitable. The Witch King will return and will destroy Arnor. Now, this didn't end historically or lore-friendly, but both kings here died. So, King Arveleg. So, yeah, that's actually who it really was. So, Paladin Bob getting 4,000 kills. Or, no, actually, this is Lord Rook or whatever getting 4,000. Paladin Bob getting 3,000. And here's the kills of the attackers. Here's the stats in case I'll just go pretty near. You can pause it. 444 with his Rangers. Good God. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. And I will see you next time.